Hello, Nancy. Now let us speak about cell organelles in part two of this video. Cell organelles, they are the small structures scattered in the cytoplasm which work together to carry out the life process. The various cell organelles, they perform different functions in a coordinated way. Let us see each one of them. The first cell organelle is also a control organelle, which is nothing but nucleus. And this nucleus consists of double membrane called as nuclear envelope. And this nuclear envelope is a discontinuous feature. And the small openings are called as nuclear pore, which helps in exchange of materials between cytoplasm and inner side of the nucleus. Component inside this nuclear envelope is called as nucleoplasm, and the nucleoplasm consists of darkly stained particles called as nucleolus, which helps in synthesis of proteins. The nucleoplasm also has scattered chromatin network, which becomes thicker and condensed and are converted into chromosomes when the cell is about to divide. And this chromosomes consists of DNA and genes, which are termed as hereditary vehicles of the cell. Next cell organelle is mitochondria, which are small rod-like structure or sausage-shaped structure, which also has dual membrane. The inner membrane is folded and is called as cristae. The mitochondria also has its own DNA and ribosomes, so it is termed as semi-autonomous cell organelle. There are liquid components present even in mitochondria, and it is termed as a matrix. Since this mitochondria is involved in production of energy currency of the cell, that is nothing but ATP, mitochondria is also called as powerhouse of the cell. Next cell organelle is ribosomes, which are small, round, present in large number in living cell, which are made up of ribosomal RNA and ribosomal protein. Mainly it helps in synthesis of protein. Based on the presence of ribosomes, it is categorized on its function segregation. If ribosomes are attached to the outer membrane of endoplasmic reticulum, the function is to produce enzymatic proteins, hormonal proteins, lysosomal proteins, and proteins of the cell membrane. Whereas, if the ribosomes are freely distributed in the cytoplasm, they synthesize proteins of hemoglobin and peroxisome. Based on the location of ribosomes, ribosomes can be considered as prokaryotic ribosome and eukaryotic ribosome. The prokaryotic ribosome is of 70S type and eukaryotic ribosome is of 80S type, and the letter S stands for Swedberg constant or sedimentation constant. Endoplasmic reticulum. This endoplasmic reticulum is divided into smooth endoplasmic reticulum and the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum helps in synthesis of lipids, and there are no any ribosome attached to its surface. Whereas ribosomes are attached to the outer surface of rough endoplasmic reticulum, and the function is to synthesize proteins. Next cell organelle is Golgi apparatus or Golgi body of Golgi complex, which is discovered by Camillo Golgi, and the function is storage, modification, and packaging of cell products. These products are received from endoplasmic reticulum, and the Golgi apparatus has two phases. One is cis phase and the other one is trans phase. The cis phase is also known as receiving end, and the trans phase is also known as releasing end. From the cis phase, the Golgi apparatus receives the molecule from endoplasmic reticulum, so package and modify it and release it from the transcend where it is delivered to the target site. Next cell organelle is lysosome, which is popularly called as suicidal batch of the cell, because this lysosome consists of lipid bilayer, and inner to that it consists of mixture of hydrolytic enzymes. If at all a cell is infected by any pathogen or the germ, this lysosomes will break open, release its hydrolytic enzymes and digest the pathogen, because this hydrolytic enzymes consists of few enzymes like protease, which has the ability to digest proteins, nuclease, which has the ability to digest nucleic acid like base. Centrosome, this cell organelle, it consists of two perpendicular cylinders called as centrioles, which are absent in plant cell, but it is present in animal cell, and this centriole is present near to the nucleus, and the function is during cell division, especially to form the spindle fibers for the arrangement of chromosomes. Plasters, this plaster is present only in plant cell. Plaster is further categorized into chromoplast and leucoplast. The word chroma means color. Leucoplast is colorless plaster. The colored plaster is further divided into chloroplast, rhodoplast, pyoplast, whereas leucoplast is divided into amyloplast, elaioplast, and proteinoplast. Proteinoplast is also known as alluroplast. The chloroplast is extensively found in green plants, whereas the rhodoplast is containing red pigment and present in red algae. Pyoplast contains brown pigment and it is extensively present in brown algae. Amyloplast stores starch. Elaioplast stores water, oil droplets. And proteinoplast stores protein. It is also known as alluroplast. Chloroplast has a double membrane structure, outer membrane and inner membrane. In the inner membrane, within the inner membrane, it has fluid component called as a stroma, and it has got the cone-like structure called as thylakoid, and each thylakoid is stacked one over the other, and that stacking is called as a grana. Since there are many granum are involved, okay, it is termed as grana. Each granum is piled on one another to form this bundle, and it is connected to each other by lamella. And keep it in mind, like mitochondria, chloroplast also has its own DNA and ribosome. So chloroplast is also called as semi-autonomous living organism. Vacuoles, they are blank looking cell organelle which is enclosed within a membrane called as stomoplast. The plant cell consists of large central vacuole, whereas animal cell consists of small vacuoles, or vacuole may be absent in them. The difference between plant and animal cell. As you can see the picture, animal cells are generally round or irregular in shape, and it also contains centrioles, whereas plant cells are generally cubic in nature or rectangular in nature. So the difference between plant and animal cell is, plant cell consists of plaster, which is nothing but chloroplast, which is absent in plant cell, animal cell. The difference between plant and animal cell are, plant cells are usually large in size, animal cells are comparatively smaller in size. Plant cell have a cell wall, animal cell do not have cell wall. Plant cell contain chloroplast, animal cell do not contain chloroplast. Plant cell do not contain centrioles, whereas animal cell contain centrioles. Plant cell do not contain large vacuole, whereas animal cell do contain large vacuole. These are the reference which I have used especially for the pictures. Thank you.